Welcome to
Cooking with Adolce.
Yes, I'm featuring Miss Sadé Adolce. She's in the kitchen with me today. And so we are going to make homemade pizza.
And it has pepperoni, bacon bits, and a mushroom.
That's right. That's the ingredients she wanted on her pizza. So, yes, we're going to do different videos for them. Because this will end up being too long because we all kind of have our different pizzas that we wanted to make. But this is our first time making pizza at home.
I'm so excited.
Yeah, I know, right? Yes, so we're going to start off with Sade's pizza that she wanted to make. And so, yeah, stay tuned, y'all. All right, so as for the ingredients, it's a lot going on over here. First off, of course you can really do homemade, but we ain't making no straight up dough from scratch. But if you do want to do a dough, a pizza crust, you can get it like this. But I don't even think I'm going to do that. I got two different options. They actually have pre-made pizza. So this one is an artisan thin pizza crust from Stonefire. It's got about 4 in there and it's 12 inches. But then you also got, I think this is 6 inches. It's like a personal size pizza. And this is the thin and crispy from Mama Mary's. So it's got 3 in this pack, 4 in this pack. Got them from Publix. And yeah, so I think what we're gonna do is do like 1 12-inch and 2 personal ones. So if we wanna share out of this one, you know, and then of course Shada got her own little personals. So yes, that's the crust. For the sauce, you can either make it from scratch with, well, you know, think like how you're making spaghetti and stuff. But this is the puree and finely chopped tomatoes. But you can also just buy some pizza sauce. I kind of be liking to do a mixture of both. This is diced onions and minced garlic, which I am going to saute to put into the sauce. It's not really something that you gotta do. I saw recipes where they're just like you just put it on there, but me, I'm thinking like how I do my spaghetti. I'm going to saute that and then put it on there so it just tastes real good, be flavorful, you know what I'm saying. Then pepperoni, I'm going to drain this and kind of pat it dry so it's not wet and makes the pizza too watery. But this is the mushrooms. We got some individual pepperoni. And we got some crumbled bacon bits. Which I have bacon pieces too. Because you know you got different types of bacon. But we like to put bacon on everything. So you can do the crumbled bacon or actual chopped bacon. So the pieces are a little bit bigger. It's whatever.
I think we should do both.
Well, we will do it. And okay, cheese. You can do cheddar or mozzarella cheese. I like the triple cheddar. And I'm going to do a little of mozzarella because I'm going to put this one on my seafood pizza. And I even got Italian blend pizza because it's going to be good. You don't have to do all that. Y'all can do just straight cheddar. But of course, you can get as creative and do the most as you want to make it more flavorful. So I'm going to do a mixture of that. At least this and the Italian blend cheese. You know, we got butter. But I want to make like a garlic butter, so you can add a little, no, you can add a little garlic powder to the butter. But also today I saw that Kerrygold has a garlic herb butter, so I'm gonna put a little of that on the crust, make sure that tastes good. Seasonings, you can get a straight up pizza seasoning. Yeah, it's got all the seasonings already in there. Or you know, you can do your garlic, salt, pepper, the Italian seasoning, which has, you know, the basic seasonings, and then a little parsley that you can kind of sprinkle on the top, make it look good, make it look cute. So Yes, and I got the spoon so you can spread the sauce onto the pizza crust. I got the baster if I want to baste like some little butter or something on the crust with that to make sure it tastes good. And of course, you know, your cast iron skillet. Also, you can use a flat cookie sheet, or you know, if you got little pizza ones. I got the ones with the holes in there to kind of let more heat in there so it'll be a little more crisp. And then of course, if you're going to use the pizza crust, then you can use a little roller to roll it out if you want to. You ain't got to do all that. The link will be in the description box, and you can use a knife to cut it or get you one of these little cutters. But I got the little safety thing on it. You know, you got kids, you gotta make sure you're safe. And Sade's instructions on how she want to divide up her ingredients. We do half and half and all this on there and all that. So yeah, that is per Sade. All right, y'all, so that is the ingredients. Pick and choose what you want to do. You ain't got to do the most if you want to. If you want to get a little fancy with it, you know, but I got the ingredients out here, so you saw what we're doing. But we are about to get started. You ready? Yay. All right, y'all, stay tuned. All right, first things first, if you're going to use mushrooms and not the kind that's already dried, then I'm just going to take these and drain them. Okay. And then just kind of put them in this bowl.
Looks like it's a little bit of some water still in there.
Right, well, you're going to get it out. Here you go, fancy Sade. Yeah, we're draining it first just so it'll have time to kind of dry out before we get to putting them on there. They're not going to be just completely dry, but at least it's just not sitting in water, you know. Like I say, it'll probably make it runny. I think we may just cut them a little bit more, huh? Mm-hmm.
That way the pizza will have more mushrooms.
Mm-hmm. You just can't cut while you're a kid, though, right now. You know what I mean? But you'll be doing it. I'm sure you're going to be a great cook.
I think probably too.
Because you like it. You always up in here when I'm doing something.
Well, yeah, I do like cooking with you.
Mm-hmm. So, I think you'll do great. All right, so we chopped them up. I did put them in the microwave just, you know, 30, 40 seconds just to kind of dry it out a little bit more. And I'm going to sit this paper towel over it so it can be still soaking up some of the water while we're working on some other stuff. So, that's why I started out with that first. All right, now I'm gonna get some butter and put some garlic powder and stuff on there just so that, especially since it's pre-made, or if you're doing the crust, you can, you know, do it in a skillet and put some butter on there too. I would advise, just so it ain't just completely plain and got some flavor. So
that looks like some ice cream.
I know it does look like ice cream, huh?
Actually, I like cupcakes.
Yeah.
I haven't ate ice cream, but I've ate cupcakes before.
Mm-hmm. You had ice cream before. I don't think you like it that much, though, because it's cold. You don't like it too cold, huh?
Actually, I don't like it because sometimes when you leave it out, it gets, you know, melty.
Yeah, that's it. That's what it is. I just know usually you don't want no ice cream too cold. Okay, so, and then I'm just going to throw a little garlic powder on it and do some Italian seasoning. Why not? I got it.
That smells delicious.
Right. All right, I'm about to melt this
in the microwave.
That's right.
Ooh.
Right.
It smells delicious.
It does.
Even looks delicious, doesn't
it? Okay. All right, so then I just preheated the oven, getting it started to 425, because it's really like you're broiling it. You know what I mean? It's gonna be pretty much cooked. So, okay. Let me get this over here. I'm gonna get you this one.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And then I got this one. You know what? Since we're gonna do two, I'm gonna put it on. All right, y'all. It's not cute, but we're gonna use this so you can fit two of them on there, since that's what you want to do.
Because we are making three pizzas.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I got that open, and we're gonna sit these two over here like this. What we're going to do is put some butter on it first.
And by that, my mom made the pizza.
Mm-hmm. And so we're going to kind of do it like this. Just so it'll be flavorful, the crust.
I can't even see the butter.
Mm-hmm. Let's see. I think I'm going to do both sides.
Thinking.
Mm-hmm, because we're doing a pre-made crust, and you know how they can go, y'all, when you're doing something pre-made. So just add some flavor on it, make it taste good, you know.
Because my pizza is going to be tasting delicious.
It is.
Because after all, we are making a pre-made pizzas.
Mm-hmm.
And we are be able to share them with the family. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's a little fancy voice, just in case y'all wonder.
That's my fancy Paris voice, because I really like Paris.
Yes, she be watching Fancy Nancy. And she is obsessed with going to France one day. So that is definitely on the bucket list, because we even be looking up French words, how to say stuff in French. So she is really invested.
And I also have a paper with all the French words. Well, some of them.
She does. She really does. I had to show you. She got it on the refrigerator.
I'll get it off.
Okay. And that in your Paris chart with the Eiffel Tower. By the way, that's the butter part, but she finna show y'all her little Paris words off the refrigerator. Yes. This is her list of Paris words that we sat in the bed one day just looking up how to say different stuff. So that's au revoir. What's au revoir?
Au revoir means, what does it mean again?
Bye.
Au
revoir
means bye.
Uh-huh. What is bonjour?
Bonjour means hello.
That's right. What was bon après-midi? I think that was good evening, wasn't it? It's like a greeting for the afternoon.
Actually,
or something.
Bon après-midi means good afternoon and good night.
Look at you. Okay. No, I think good night is bon nuit.
Bon nuit means good night.
That's right. What does s'il vous plaît?
S'il vous plaît means...
I think it was please.
S'il vous plaît means please.
What's merci? I think you should remember that one.
Merci means thank you.
Good job. So yes, y'all, she is serious about this. It's like to the point she got the list. And she even drew, what's this? Oh yeah, La Fresh Cuisine
Declare.
There you go. Okay, some she saw in Fancy Nancy. I think you eating outside, right? Something like that. So, good job. And hold on.
We have to put.
I'm sorry. So this is the picture of the Eiffel Tower where she got the numbers. so that when we raise enough money, save enough money to
go to Paris.
That's her little chart, which I told her it may be a while before I do that.
Oh, can you show them the back of this too?
What's the back of it? What's that?
This is how to say some other things in French.
I got it. Okay, go ahead.
This says, Joyeux anniversaire, Joyeux anniversaire, Joyeux anniversaire.
She's actually saying it right. Listen.
Joyeux anniversaire.
See, she in kindergarten, so she just learning how to read and write. So it's definitely written in kindergarten speak. The way it sounded to her is how she spelled it, but she is actually seeing it and pronouncing it right. She knows what she's talking about. Oh, okay. You were singing it one day, so you wrote that. Got you. What does that mean?
That's how you say a happy birthday.
Okay, nice. That's why you sang it like that. I should have known. Duh. Okay, nice. Look at you, girl. You is determined. Look, she even drew the picture of us going to Paris. Me, her, and Sanaa, and Robin too.
Ma, that's a poodle.
Okay, well, the poodle. I just assumed it was Robin.
Let me explain.
With the Eiffel Tower. Go
let
ahead.
Let me explain what this is.
Okay.
These are birds. That's the mime. That's a lady walking her poodle. And that's me in Paris.
Okay. That's just you in Paris.
And that's also the Louvre. And that's the Eiffel Tower.
She's most definitely right. Looking at the picture, she definitely intended to draw the Louvre and the Eiffel Tower. I see.
That's how they say it in Paris.
That is how they say it.
And that's also bird seeds with the orange.
Yes. Good job, honey. Good job.
Just so y'all can see, I'm going to let her explain to y'all about fencing and where she's getting all this from.
This is my favorite Fancy Nancy video. And it has all the episodes of it. I mean, 6 of them. These are some pictures I saw in the music start of it.
Mm-hmm.
Fancy Nancy is a fancy girl and she speaks French sometimes. Mm-hmm. She is really determined to go to France, just like me, because I really want to go to France.
Mm-hmm.
And that's her dog, Frenchie.
So that's the poodle that's over here on the picture. So that's the poodle over there.
Mm-hmm. And she called her dog Frenchie because of something, and that's Fancy Nancy there.
Yeah, I see.
That's her mom. And that's her little sister Jojo.
Okay, cute. And then turn around and see the front. So if y'all wondering what we talking about and where she just really got into friends, she was looking at this on Disney Plus and she liked it so much that I just bought her the series on the DVD too. And
this also says ooh la la.
I know.
It has an episode that is an ooh la la spa one.
Welcome to the ooh la la spa.
Yeah, she's really excited about that because actually that's something she said she wants us to do for Mother's Day. So when I finish posting this, we're supposed to be doing a spa, which I don't know how she's going to do it, but I'm just assuming we're just going to be all doing our nails and feet and face mask type stuff, so it should be cute. But yeah, she was really amped about this episode and wanted me to know about it.
Oh, nice. Cute, baby. I love it. So this is kind of turned into, because I know pizza is Italian, and I guess I don't know if Paris is just big on pizza. I think they're big on croissants, but maybe it fits the theme. But this has turned into a fancy affair. All right, let's get back to our pizza, which you did great, honey. So fancy. So ooh la la, Trey Chic.
Bye.
Yeah. Beautiful. All right, let's get back to the pizza. All right, so now we're about to do the sauce. I'm going to show you, because like I said, I have pizza sauce. And if you just want to throw that on there and you don't care about doing the most, you want to make it quick and easy, you can definitely do that. But me, I am going to kind of saute my stuff, and I'm going to show you how to do both. And like I say, I'm new to this myself, but you know, I know about spaghetti and stuff, so you know. But yes, it said something about puree and chopped tomatoes. But if you don't want to do all that, you can just do pizza sauce. And if you still want to warm it up and all that, do that. But I'm going to start with my onions. I got some that's pre-chopped, so I ain't have to go into doing the most with that. First, we're going to turn it on. Throw some butter in there a little bit. And let that melt down. Okay, so I'm going to put a little onions in there. You could do a whole onion. I may do half of this. Okay, so I did a little bit more than half, about half of that. Or just do your whole chopped onion. Add a little minced garlic in there. And add some seasoning. I'm gonna do some Italian seasoning. A little garlic powder. Regular salt. Pepper. And just because I have it, I'm going to add some of this pizza seasoning. You do not have to, but I'm going to do it just because I got it. So I think it got little red pepper flakes and stuff like that in there. So my baby. Love you too, baby. All right, so I got the onions and garlic and seasonings cooked down pretty good. Again, you don't have to do that, but I'm gonna do it because I know it's gonna taste good. And I'm gonna put some to the side because of course I'm gonna mix some in the sauce, but I may just spread some on the pizza with the other toppings. So just kind of doing that. Half and half. All right, so the puree, I'm gonna open it up and put 2 tablespoons of puree. And of course you don't have to measure it. You can just eyeball it and put in there what you deem necessary. But if you got measuring stuff, do 2 tablespoons roughly of that. And I can tell you now, that don't look like a lot. They must be talking about for one pizza. Chad, I'm not following that. You put about as much puree as you think you need to put in there. Because, see, if you was doing one pizza, maybe. But I'm not. I'm going to keep that to the side. You just do whatever that makes sense to you. All right. So, the chopped onions, I'm going to add some of that in there. It said a can. Even though I didn't see it in a can, it had this big old carton of it. Okay, add some crushed onions. I mean, mix that in with the onions. And then, of course, you need to season it up. So we're gonna do some more Italian seasoning. Think of it if you like making spaghetti sauce, minus the bell peppers, because I ain't got no bell peppers in there. Oh, let me turn it down some. Some black pepper, salt. And I'm going to put some more. Hold on. It's gonna be a mess. Some more of my pizza seasoning. honestly, old school. They say do a pinch of sugar just to get a little of that tomato-y taste out of it. You know, I don't even know what to say. But not too much where it's sweet. I'm pretty much making this like spaghetti sauce. Yeah. For the most part. If I wanted to, I could add some pizza sauce. But like I say, if you want to do the pizza sauce yourself, saute your onions and just throw straight pizza sauce in there. Fine. If you want to do the pizza sauce without even warming it up at all, you can do that, y'all. This just me doing some little extra to make sure it tastes good, because when you're getting over the counter stuff, you just don't know. You just don't know. But the sauce looking pretty good. So it's bubbling up. I think that's gonna be good. You want to be my taste tester, Sadé? Okay. It's a little hot. Just take a little bit. It tastes good. Mm. All right. Can you rinse the spoon now?
It does not taste bad at all.
Good. So that should be some good tomato pizza sauce. Good, it should be. Alright, so we're gonna turn the tomato sauce off. And now we are about to build the pizza. Mm-hmm. Alright, so now we are ready to start dressing the pizza.
And let's start with our mushroom.
Hold on, we gotta take that off. Take the paper towel off of them first. We are going to put the sauce on there. That's what we gotta do. Sauce. Hold on, let me get my cooling rack.
To cool off the pizza.
That sauce got to be close by, but it's still kind of hot on that thing. So let me get that over here. All right, that's our sauce. We're gonna put that nearby. And now we both got spoons, huh?
Is the red one for me?
Yep, the red one's for you.
Thank you.
You're welcome. So, all right, scoop you some out, okay? And then put it on the pizza and spread it around like this. Look how I'm doing. Or we can pour some on there, but yeah, hold on, let me help you out. All right, spread it around good.
And spreading it around really good. Mm-hmm. Oh, actually, that's enough sauce for me.
Okay.
I'll do the spreading it.
Well, don't spread it too much because you got too much crust showing. I'm trying to make sure it's got the sauce under it, baby. Okay, hold on. We making a mess now. I'm gonna put it all the way out there. Okay. We want to keep it on the pizza. All right. Mm. Okay.
I'll put my spoon down right now.
Okay, we'll put it over here. Let me see if I can wipe up some of it. That's going to be
a mess
in that doggone oven. It may be fine, but I'm just going to make sure I got it a little bit more neat.
I like how it's going right now. Mm-hmm. I really like how my pizza is looking.
Yes.
But it's going to look even better when we're done with our pizza.
That's right.
I'm just so excited because this is our first time making pizza together.
It is.
And we've never made pizza together, but now today we are.
Yep, and it's, which it should turn out well, we'll be making it more often because I No, I'm excited for my seafood pizza, and I think Sanaa want to do buffalo ranch chicken pizza. So y'all stay tuned for those as well, or if you already watched it and don't to this one, cool.
So depending on when you watch this video, the seafood pizza did turn out really good. So I haven't dropped it yet as of Mother's Day, but if you're watching this later, it should be linked above.
All right, now we're going to sprinkle some seasoning. So I'm going to take the Italian seasoning.
Can I sprinkle. Try with mine?
Uh-huh. Go ahead. But try to do it lightly and spread it around. Mm-hmm. Get on that side. Looks like you didn't get none on that side. All right. And then also we'll put a little of this pizza seasoning.
I'll do some of mine too.
I know. I got you, honey. Here you go. Mhm. All right. A little bit more.
Oh, too much.
All right. Now we're gonna put the cheese on there.
Because pizza does need cheese.
Yep. We're gonna do some triple cheddar cheese.
I'll put some on mine.
Okay. Go ahead and grab you a little bit and sprinkle it all like this. You see how I'm doing?
Uh-huh.
All around it. All right. We wanna get plenty of good cheese, even though we're mixing cheeses. Mozzarella shredded cheese. Then we got another cheese. This one I got because I'm doing a seafood pizza, but we're gonna put something on this one too.
And I'll do some by myself of mine, mm-hmm. Since I'm doing it right now.
I got you, honey. I'm just doing
what you're doing by myself of my pizza, okay. Because I want a chance doing something by myself with my cheese, with
bigger.
My pizza.
Mm-hmm.
There we go. Some cheese.
Mm-hmm. Listen, I'm working on some classwork, so. We were going to all do them together, but we'll just do it individually, and that's that. Okay.
And that's enough right now.
Now, it's time for the toppings.
Ooh.
First, let's get a little onions that I set aside and just put some on there, just so to be some extra. It don't have to be a lot, but it's gonna add to it and make it good. Yeah. Hold on, honey. All right.
Can I get a paper towel? I don't want my hands to be like this when I'm doing, you know.
That's fine. All right, so we got the onions on there.
Next, mushroom.
Okay, now I think you said you were doing one of yours with mushrooms and one of the small ones without?
Yes.
Okay, and then this one we were gonna do half mushroom and half not, because I don't like mushroom. And if she want a piece of your pizza, it don't have it on. Since we eat some of each other's pizza, we was gonna share one of them, half of one. Okay, that's a lot of mushrooms. You gotta spread it all over. Spread it out. You ain't gotta put all of them on there. You ain't gotta put too much unless you want to. But just remember, we still got other ones we're putting on there. Now, let's do some bacon bits.
This is thicker.
She wanted that on that much. All right, you said you wanted to mix them up, so I got some crumbled, and we also got the chopped bacon. I think we putting bacon all over all of them.
There, just a little bit of some bacon shreds.
Right, because you see how big that is? That's chopped bacon. That's the difference in the crumbles.
Now I have a little bit more bacon for my pizza.
Mm-hmm.
I can't wait to eat my pizza when it's done.
Mm-hmm.
Mom?
Mm-hmm.
Can I taste one of these?
A piece of bacon?
Okay.
Okay. Good. All right. Okay, now the pepperoni. Let's get the pepperonis on there.
This is the last step.
That's right. All right. Here go your son to spread out.
Thank you.
You're welcome. All right, so just press them down on there like that. Press it down, honey. Like. Mm-hmm. I'll drizzle some butter over it. Oh, you still snuck some piece of bacon.
Wanted to eat some more.
You're feeding hungry.
Well, yes, I am hungry.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, when we do that, we'll put some more seasoning on there, and then it'll be there. All right, so now a little garlic butter mixture. Just gonna drizzle some on there. Yeah, make it good.
I'll do some too.
Because it's hot. I just took it out the microwave. All right.
There we go.
And then we'll add a little bit more seasoning just to top it all off.
I got it.
Go ahead. Okay, and also, why not add a little more cheese?
Me too.
Yes, we'll sprinkle a little more cheese on the top.
I really like how my pizza's
going. Yeah, it looks really yummy.
Yeah, it looks so yummy, you know.
Mm-hmm, get some on them edges. All right.
Well, at least I got some cheese.
Mm-hmm. We might as well use the rest of these because this is about gone. We'll do that. A little bit more of the mozzarella cheese. Alright, this is the last one. Sprinkle a little bit of that on there. It's going to be good.
Pizza is going great.
Uh-huh. It's definitely loaded.
It's a very loaded pizza.
And now
a little bit more
to put it in the oven.
And then when we're done, we can cut it and eat.
Uh-huh. And we went on and put it at 450, so it'll be like it's broiling. Are you able to carry this? Okay. Come down off the thing first. Alright, be careful.
You mean putting it in the oven?
Yeah. Right, we got it on 450. No, I'm going to put it in there. I just needed you to hold it and pass it to me.
Here you go.
All right. So now I want some mozzarella sticks. Okay. So the pizza, I think like 6 or 7 minutes or something like that. All right, y'all, so we got it in there for 6 minutes on 450, and then we'll take it out and see how it looks. But it looks good so far. Oh, let's see. I can't wait to see how it looks. You excited? No, you're still over there eating stuff.
All right,
and so this is the pizza. Go ahead, we do the taste test. Is it good?
Tastes good.
Good, good. Great job, honey. We make a good team. All right. It is good. Okay, you did that. You did that.
It smells good.
Mm-hmm. All right, y'all. So, what you think of it?
I think the pizza tastes delicious.
Yes, magnifique. As we thank you guys for watching. Let us know how it turned for you in the comment section. And thank you for watching Cooking with the Dolce.
Bye.
Bye.
I'm wishing y'all a happy Mother's Day, and you can either click off or stay tuned for this little mini blog that I added in today of today's Mother's Day this morning.
Happy Mother's Day, Mom.
Oh, thank you, honey. You and Sonata made the cheese and bacon bagel.
It's all yours.
Oh, thank you, sweetie. And then y'all done brought me little gifts.
And this one is from me.
Let me see what you got, honey. I was editing this, trying to get it done, this video, and so it's Mother's Day. Okay. Happy Mother's Day to Mom from Sade. Nice. And then you got a little flower that you kind of cut out and put on there.
The flower was from the Mother's Day, too.
Okay. Nice. Thank you, sweetie.
I glued it in there because I thought it would make it more sweet.
Well, thank you. I will put it up there with the rest of my Mother's Day stuff that I could eat. What's that one? I think that's the envelope she called us to make it for it, ain't it? Show the envelope.
It looks pretty.
And the back is also purple dotted.
Mm-hmm. Look at the little Robin in the mix. Hey, Robin. Hey, sweetie. Happy Mother's Day, too. This is cute. Let me see what y'all done got me.
That's your dress.
It's a medium size.
I know my hands been gaining some weight. Okay, cute. Aw, thank you, baby.
I was going back and forth debating whether I needed to get a pink bear or a red bear, but I decided to get red only because your room...
Right.
Is red, and that's they didn't true. Have a red dress, so I was just like, you know what? Also, I didn't. Also, it's like this is it's very much giving Valentine's Day,
yeah, but that's it's cool though. It's cool because you know I used to have a pink dress, and I had that other ruching one, but it was a small. It definitely I can't fit that. So thank you, honey. I have to try it on. This should be cute.
I hope you like it.
I do. I do. You got me a bear.
Aww. I wish I could have blown the balloon up, but we don't have an air pump, so so it's just finna be just there.
But you didn't order the balloon.
No, the balloon came with a...
With this?
Yeah.
This is cute.
Open up the thing, because it has other things in it.
Has a card in here.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And another little gift.
Okay. Oh, it's something else in here. Wait, take the bear out?
No, don't take the bear out.
Okay.
I did the most trying to put it in.
Okay. Okay, let me see what this is.
Because I had to wrap around the this.
This is cute. It's like a heart necklace or something.
Mm-hmm. With a message inside.
It's like Valentine's Day.
It does. I didn't even...
Aww.
It has a little message inside of it. I had one of these before.
Mm-hmm.
I forgot how you see the message in it, but
hold on. So, do I look at it from this? side. I need to look at it from. But it's supposed to be a message in this part.
Yes, I think it says something about either I love you or...
Yeah, she's showing what it's supposed to look like.
It's supposed to say I love you in 100 languages, I believe.
Aww.
That's why it's so many going on.
That's cool. I like this. Thank you, sweetie.
No problem.
Yeah, so it is flipped backwards. But yeah, you can see it right there. It says I love you.
Hey. Well, it has a heartfelt message in there.
It's cute. And then, okay. Happy Mother's Day from Sanaa and Sade to Mommy. Hey, love you. Dear Mommy, thank you for always believing in us and doing everything you can to provide a stable upbringing for me and Sade. We love and appreciate you very, very much. Love, Sanaa and Sade. Happy Mother's Day. We hope you enjoy your day presents. I do. Thank you. Oh. I love y'all so much.
We love you too, Mom.
So sweet. Happy my baby Mother's had a home win and got a mama some stuff. I love y'all.
We love you too.
Are you enjoying it, Mommy?
I am enjoying it. Y'all started my morning off good. Mm-hmm. I'm finna eat.
We can start the other stuff at 12.
Yeah, we'll start the other stuff at 12. I'm finna finish this video. As far as just laying the music, and then we're going to finish our day. Thank y'all. Love you.
Love you too.
Happy Mother's Day, everybody out there.
Y'all, look at Robin.
Robin!
Ah! Good morning, Robin. You look so small on camera, but I know you ain't on in real life.
Y'all, this is the dress. I guess it drapes down. And yeah. Big
got that food popping even good. I'm through. But yes,
y'all like it. This is the dress my daughter's got me. Ah.
Happy Mother's Day, y'all.
I'm
about to enjoy the rest of our day. Oh, also look at the bear there. Look at this bear.
I know, it's so cute. Bye. Bye, y'all. Happy Mother's Day.